What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about upgrading AD Connect to the latest and greatest. So let's get right into it. All right, so today is all about upgrading your Azure Active Directory Connect to sync to the Microsoft 365 tenant. So I am logged into my domain controller because that's where I have my Azure AD Connect client installed. So if I open up the control panel, you're going to see that my Microsoft Azure AD Connect is running 2.3.2.0. It's pretty old. Microsoft, you know, hasn't complained about it, but I typically like to upgrade it just to make sure we're good to go, right? Well, to make sure I'm good to go. So I'm going to click on the start button. I am going to locate Azure AD Connect. We're going to click on that folder to expand it. We're going to click on Azure AD Connect and we're going to load it up. Once you load up Azure AD Connect, it's going to stop the services. And the reason why we're loading this up because we want to download our settings. In case something happens, we are able to recover quickly. So we're going to click on configure. Within here, we're going to locate and click on view or export current configuration. So click on it and click on next. Now, click on that big button that says export settings, and you're going to get a dialog box. We're going to drop it into, you know, I'm going to drop it in my desktop, but it's really up to you. Click on save. Done. We're going to exit out of this. Now, next thing that we need to do is go into your Microsoft 365 tenant and download the MSI file to start the installation. Now, I already did that already. It's on the downloads folder, and I'm going to right click on that MSI file. I am going to click on install. It's going to start validating the installation. And for my case, most likely you might not have this, but for me, I received this. The installation requires TLS 1.2, but it was not enabled on the server. So I'm running server 2016 as my Active Directory, and I don't have this enabled. So I did a little bit of Googling, and there's 4 registry settings that we need to configure and then reboot your domain controller. Well, for me, I had to reboot my domain controller. Most likely, you guys don't have your Azure AD Connect client installed within your domain controller. I know it's really bad practice. I'm sorry. I did some Googling, and these are the 4 that we need to run. Now, I right-clicked on the start menu. I clicked on command prompt as an admin. I load this up and I ran each one of them until it said the operation completed successfully. And I rebooted my domain controller, right? Now, again, hopefully you guys have your Azure AD client not installed within your domain controller. You are able to install it on to another server. And then you're able to just reboot that server. Now, once it was rebooted, got back into the desktop, and you don't need to start the MSI file again because on the desktop, they got this cool looking Azure AD icon. If you double click on it, it's going to load up the Microsoft Intra Connect Sync. Once it loads up, you're going to get this, which is a great thing. We want to upgrade it. It bypassed that TLS requirement because we, you know, we enable it within my Windows Server 2016. So from here, we're going to click on upgrade. Once this is done, it's going to go to the next step. And we need to enter a username that has global admin access. So enter that, click on next. Once you click on next, you're going to get this dialog box. You need to enter your email address. Make sure that email address or that account has full admin or actually global access within the tenant. Once you enter that information, click on next. Provide a password, click on sign in. It should take you here, which is good. It's ready to configure. Definitely leave, start the synchronization process when the configuration is completed because you want to do it a sync right away. So click on upgrade. It's going to start configuring the Microsoft Intra Connect sync and boom, configuration is done. And that's it, you know, and just exit out. And you're done. I mean, the next thing that you can actually do is just go inside your Microsoft 365 admin center and just make sure that the status has changed, that it's green and it's syncing, which is good. If you open up the control panel on the server that has the AD Connect, you're going to see that now you're running version 2.4.21.0. And hopefully this is the latest one. If not, just grab the latest one and just do the same process to get yourself up and running. And that's it, guys. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.